Are you curious how AI Assistant can help you build applications? In this video, we'll build a small Java Spring Boot application using IntelliJ IDEA and JetBrains AI Assistant. First, we will create a new project. We can do so from the welcome screen by clicking the button New Project, or if we already have a project open, from the main menu by selecting File, New Project. In the New Project dialog, select Spring Initializer on the left. Change the name of the project to Greetings App. Select Create Git Repository to add the project to version control. Select Maven as the type and click Next. In the next screen, we can select which version of Spring Boot we want to use. We'll go with the latest stable version, which is currently 3.2.2. We can also select which dependencies we want to add to our project. Expand the section Web under Dependencies and select Spring Web. Click Create. As you can see, IntelliJ IDEA has created the Spring Boot project for you with a default Maven project structure, application class, and a POM XML, including the dependency we selected when creating the project. You can open the POM XML to see the dependencies. Let's add some code to this project. First, we need to add a class. In the Project Tool window on the left, select the directory Source Main Java Greetings App. Add a new Java file using the shortcut Command-N on macOS or Alt-Insert on Windows and Linux. Name this class Home Controller. Next, we can add a comment to the code describing what we want to do. As you can see, this comment is quite specific. When we press Enter after the comment, AI Assistant will suggest code that implements the described functionality. Press Tab to accept the suggested code. Some of the code is shown in red, which means there are some issues. IntelliJ IDEA can help you resolve them. Use F2 to navigate to the next problem, or Shift F2 to navigate to the previous problem. And use Show Context Actions, Option Enter on macOS, or Alt Enter on Windows and Linux to see suggestions on how to solve the problem, for example, to import the relevant class. We can run the application by clicking the green Run button at the top right, or using Control R on macOS, or Shift F10 on Windows and Linux. The application is running on localhost. When we open our browser and point to localhost, you see we get a white label error page.
That's not right. Let's see if we can use AI Assistant to fix the problem.
There are several ways we can ask AI Assistant to help us fix the problem. First off, we can ask directly in the chat. Open the AI Assistant chat window on the right and type your question. For example, why does this code return a white label error page? As AI Assistant is powered by LLMs, the result is not deterministic. For the same request, you might get a different response. It might also take some fine-tuning of the prompt to get the desired answer. In general, the more detailed your question, the more specific the result will be. We see that, among other things, AI Assistant suggests that we need to ensure that our class is annotated with REST controller. Alternatively, we can use a predefined action from the list of AI actions called Find Problems to see whether this will include the solution to our problem. Right-click in the editor to open the context menu including AI actions, or select AI actions in the floating toolbar and select the option Find Problems. This will open a chat window with a predefined prompt, including the selected code. Once again, AI Assistant suggests we need to add the annotation REST controller to our class. We can copy the suggested code from the chat window into our code by clicking the Insert Snippet at Caret button. Now we can run the application again and go to localhost to see the result. As you can see, we get Hello World if we don't provide a parameter name. Alternatively, we can add a name. I'll add my own. And we see that we get the result, Hello Marit. Next, let's add some tests to our application. Of course, we can do this ourselves. We can navigate to existing tests or create a test file if there aren't any tests yet using the shortcut Shift-Command-T on macOS or Control-Shift-T on Windows and Linux. As you can see, IntelliJ IDEA supports a number of testing frameworks, including JUnit 5. In the test class, we can use Generate, Command-N on macOS or Alt-Insert on Windows and Linux, and select Test Method to add a test. Give the test a name that explains the intended behavior and add the relevant test code. Alternatively, we can have AI Assistant generate unit tests for us. Let's delete the class we just created and try again using AI Assistant. Open the context menu in the editor and select the option AI Actions, Generate Unit Tests. Note that AI Assistant can only generate unit tests for methods in the class.
If you get the message, test generation is not supported for the target code element, make sure to select this option from a method in your code. AI Assistant will generate tests in a new file. If we are happy with the tests that have been created, we can select Accept All. If not, we can either fine-tune them by selecting Specify and providing an additional prompt to ask AI to improve the result. Alternatively, we can click the button to regenerate the tests. When we accept the result, we can run all tests, Option-Shift-R on macOS or Control-Shift-F10 on Windows and Linux. If the tests pass, we know that there are no compilation issues and the tests can run. However, never trust a test you haven't seen fail. We want to make sure that the tests will also fail if they get the wrong result. Let's change the expected result in the tests and run them again. Now we see that they fail. Undo the changes and keep the result. You might want to think about whether the generated tests cover everything you want to cover. Do they include not just the happy flows, but also unhappy flows and exceptions? We can either add additional tests ourselves or ask AI Assistant to generate specific test cases for us.
In this video, we've seen how IntelliJ IDEA and JetBrains AI Assistant can help us build a small Java Spring Boot application more quickly. To build something more complicated, we can use the same steps, but different prompts. How would you expand this application, or what would you build instead? Please tell us in the comments.